We will solve an interesting problem of projectile in this. A ball is thrown from a height of 1.05 meters from the ground at an angle of 45 degrees, and the velocity is 10 root 2. And it is thrown in such a way that it has a wall facing it. I am throwing it towards the wall. Wall facing it, it is 4 meters. So the ball will go like a projectile and will strike the wall. It is given that when it strikes here, this collision is elastic. It is an elastic collision. And then we have to find, once it collides here, where it will fall on the ground. It will rebound certainly, where it will fall on the ground. So first thing we should know here is that, suppose a ball is coming towards the wall, it can come in three ways. One is that when it strikes the wall, it strikes it horizontally. So it has only the horizontal component. Or it could have struck it like this. It can strike the wall like this. So here, if it strikes like this, it has horizontal component and vertical component also of the velocity at the time of striking. Or it can strike like this. It can have horizontal component and vertical component. It can strike in three possible situations. First, we should find out when it is striking, which is the situation, whether it is this one, or this one. So such thing can be easily found. Suppose you take this as a reference, means if you take just take this as a reference, ignore this height from which it has been thrown, just point of throwing we take as a reference, and in case of projectile motion, we know what is the range. The range can be found as u square sine twice theta upon g. So for a body thrown at an angle of, at certain angle from here with a certain velocity, you can find the range. I am seeing only this reference. I am just ignoring this height from where it was thrown, because then I will have to take this also. It will be falling somewhere here. But I want only this parabolic, how is the path when it strikes the wall. So that is why I have just ignored this part. I don't need for my calculation. So range, as far as this reference is concerned, for this will come as u square is 10 into 10 into 2 into sine 2 theta will be 1 upon 10. So it is, range is 20, means the half range will be 10. So had the distance of wall been 10 from this point, it would have struck horizontally. But since it is less than 10, it is less than 10. So if you take any projectile motion, this is the projectile motion, and this is the reference from where I had thrown it. This is the range. So this is r by 2, this is r by 2. So if it strikes before r by 2, certainly it will have a velocity components which will be vertical upwards and horizontal. And if it strikes after r by 2, it will have this type of velocity components. So it is important, this part is important here. So in our case, since we have got the distance which is less than the half range, so it is striking like this. It is striking the wall in such a way that it has the vertical velocity also. Now, we should find out now what is the distance h when it is striking. And for that, we can easily find out. First of all, we find the time taken before it strikes. We know the horizontal velocity doesn't change. So time of flight will be, horizontal speed is ux is 10. Root 2 upon root 2, we have already found is 10. So we know the speed is distance upon time. So this distance, say x upon time, and this distance is given as 4. So this is 4. So we get time as 10 is equal to 4 upon t. So t is 2 upon 5 second is the time taken. Now, what is the height when it is striking? We know that s is equal to ut plus half a t square. You just write those formula, v is equal to u plus a t, and v square is equal to u square plus twice as. These are the three formulas which we can use in the projectile motion. Now, what will be the height which it will reach? Here we can use this formula. From this point to this point, what is the height? And s would then be equal to, what is the vertical velocity? We have to take the vertical components. When we are using these formula, you have to take the vertical along that direction of the displacement. Displacement is vertically, so velocity also you have to take with the vertical component. So velocity, vertical velocity is 10 into time is 2 upon 5 minus, we will have to write because g is acting downwards. In our reference, g is acting downwards and we have taken upward motion as positive. Uy, it is a reference. Upward things we are taking as positive and downward things, vectors pointing towards downward direction will be negative. So that is why we have to take g negative. It is 10 into 2 upon 5 into 2 upon 5. Solving this, we get answer as 3.2 is the height h from this reference. So the total height h when it is striking is, total height from the ground will be 4.25. 3.2 plus 1.05, it will be 4.25 is the height from the ground. Now we have reached that stage. Now solve it using the simple projectile motion again. This is the point from where the ball rebounds. Now since when it was colliding, it had a vertical component of velocity. Just see the wall and the ball colliding like this. There is no force in the vertical direction. So whenever a ball is colliding a wall, there will be no force in the vertical direction like this. This is important point. But there is a force in the horizontal direction. Now, since it is an elastic collision, there is no loss of energy involved. And as far as the vertical velocity component is there, vertical velocity component will not change. So if there was some velocity when it is coming like this, it is striking. Just at this point, it is about to strike. This is a vertical component and this is the horizontal component. It was 10 and vertical component, we don't know. We have to find out that also. After it collides, the vertical component doesn't change, but the horizontal component reverses its direction. This is before collision and this is after collision. The vertical component of velocity will not change because there is no force acting in the vertical direction. This is the most important point. And what is the velocity? We should have find out that also. V is equal to u plus at. And so what is Vy at the point of just before collision? Will be equal to, what is the vertical velocity, was 10, and g we have to take negative because we are moving against gravity. Upward is positive, downward is negative, so g is 10 into t is 2 upon 5 2 4. So Vy was 6 meter per second. So it is like a ball being thrown from a height. Situation becomes a ball being thrown from a height of 4.25 meters with a velocity having a vertical and horizontal component. It is like this. Somewhere it will strike the ground. This is the wall from where it rebounds, or it is just like being thrown from a height. So vertical component is 6 and horizontal is 10. Now where it will fall, we have to find this. So first of all, in such problems as we have found here, time of flight is the thing which we have to find out. Now take this as a reference. From this reference, and we take velocity direction as the reference direction, so this is positive and whatever is downward will be negative. So the distance here, displacement from this point to this point is minus 4.25. Using this equation, S is equal to ut plus half at square is the main equation we use. And in this equation, now put things in vector form. The displacement, this is a very simple method. First write this equation and then write the values with sign. From this point to this point, 4.25 is the displacement, but it is negative because it is against the direction of velocity. Velocity direction is the reference direction. This is the reference direction. So it will be minus 4.25 is equal to u is 6 into t. Now acceleration g is 10, but it is downwards. So r reference g will be, a will be minus 10. A here is the gravitational acceleration, and it is against the velocity. So it is minus half 10 into 2 upon 5 into 2 upon 5. This gets cancelled. So we get as this equation, G is 10, sorry, T is not 2 upon 5, 1 minute. It is 10 upon 2 into t square. Time we have to find out. By mistake I wrote it, so it becomes minus 5t square. So equation becomes 5t square minus 6t plus 4.25 is equal to 0. So t is equal to 6 plus minus under root 36 plus 4 into 4.25 into 5 upon 2 into 5. So it comes 6 plus minus 11 upon 10. So it becomes 17 upon 10 seconds is the time taken for the ball to reach the ground. Since the horizontal velocity is 10 meter per second and which is constant, so the distance will come as the displacement x horizontal will come as 17 upon 10 multiplied by the horizontal velocity. It will be 17 meters. So a couple of concepts which we use in this problem is, first of all, use this basic equation and then write the values in terms of the direction. And for collision of a spherical body with a wall, there is no force perpendicular to the direction. When you take as the collision direction this, but there is a force perpendicular to the wall and no force along the wall. So if I take wall as the reference, no force will act along the wall, but force will act perpendicular to the wall. Since no force is acting in the vertical direction, the velocity in the vertical direction will not change at all. So that is why we have taken the same velocity which was there vertically, which was 6 in upward direction, and we have taken the same velocity, but the horizontal velocity just changes the direction. So we have taken in this way.